Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be teaching three fancy sugar pushes for my ladies who want to spice up their West Coast swing. I love teaching subjects like this because it encourages my followers to think about and apply different forms of physical expression in their basic step. The leader is responsible for what patterns we're dancing, but he's not responsible for how we dance them. And a lot of times we get so preoccupied with just following that we forget to dance. So today's lesson is geared toward helping you see all of the variety that you can add to your dancing just in the context of your basic step, and to help you learn how to apply those things while dancing socially. Before we get into the video, I just want to remind you to give it a like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss more content like this. Now let's get dancing. Okay, so let's get started learning our three fancy sugar pushes. Before we do, I just want to stress the importance that whenever we're dancing an alternative to any step, that it doesn't affect the leader's lead. Yep, so we still need him to feel as if we're dancing a basic sugar push, even though we are going to switch it up a little bit. So that's something to keep in mind as we're learning these variations. So I'll demonstrate my first variation facing the camera and then sideways so that you can follow along. So I'm going to go one, two, kick, step, lock, step. And again here, so I go one, two, kick, step, lock, step. Now, obviously the leader's right in front of me, so I can't kick directly forward. I have to turn my body about an eighth of a turn to the left and cross my right foot over to the left so that I'm not kicking him, all the while giving him pressure forward with my torso as if I were doing my triple step forward. So I go one, two. I turn my torso to the left, but I'm keeping my hands out in front of me so that I'm still giving him pressure forward so that he can then push me away. Four, and now I'm going to do a lock step instead of an anchor step, but it's going to be small steps backward so that I don't create more distance than I normally would if I were just doing my anchor step. So I'll do it one more time. I go one, two, kick, step, lock, step. Now, our second fancy sugar push is going to be a kickball change and a rotated triple step. So I'll show you facing the camera first. I go kickball change, triple step, anchor step. Or one and two, three and four, five and six. So as you can see, even though the first part is syncopated, I'm still using the six counts that I would use in a sugar push. So instead of taking the two steps forward, I'm gonna hang back, kick, ball, change to walk forward. And if I do this correctly, I will still end up in the same place that I would if I had just taken two steps forward. So I go kick, and then I'm gonna put the ball of my right foot on the ground and step forward with my left. So one more time, I go kick, ball, change. And then from here, my left side is going to be leading. I'm gonna cross my right foot behind my left instead of taking it forward like I would in my normal sugar push. So I go kick, ball, left side leading, triple step, anchor step. I'll do it one more time. I go kick, ball, change, triple step, anchor step. And again, when I do my rotated triple step, I want to make sure that I'm still giving the leader pressure forward, equal pressure forward on both sides, that I'm not taking my right side away from him, because again, that will negatively affect his lead. Now our third and final fancy sugar push is going to be an over-rotated anchor step with swivels following it. So I'll show you facing the camera. I'm gonna go do my normal sugar push to start, 3 and 4. Now instead of an anchor step, I'm gonna do a rotating sailor shuffle. Sailor shuffle to face away from the leader, and then I'm going to use this rotation to swivel toward him. Triple step, triple step. So now I'll do it one more time facing the camera and do a normal sugar push. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, and 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. Now I'll go sideways to the camera. Normal sugar push. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6, and 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. One more time. So when I do my over-rotated sailor shuffle, I'm gonna first cross my left foot behind, cross and step forward. So I'm leaving my hand where it is. It's very important that I don't start to pull him when I do that. I go 1, 2, 3, and 4. Leave the hand and just rotate your body, because if I take it with me, then I won't have any resistance to help me turn back around. So I leave this here, and then I'm gonna use our connection to help me swivel, and then instead of doing a normal triple step forward, I'm going to rotate now to the right, triple step, anchor step. I'll do it one more time. We go. Normal sugar push, 3 and 4, rotate 5 and 6. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, and 6. So those are your three fancy variations on a basic sugar push. I hope that you enjoyed them and that you found something that you liked and that you're going to try to apply next time you're out dancing socially. If this video was helpful to you, don't forget to share it with a dancing friend, give it a like, and subscribe to my channel so that you can see more videos like this one. Until next time, keep dancing.